Australian firm Call Design is introducing the first workforce optimization and management service programs here in the Philippines to help local firms cut costs and improve staff efficiency. With us now for more is Call Design Executive Director Sean Mather. Good to have you with us, Sean. Welcome to ANC.
Thank you. Very good to be with you.
Right. One of the things that your firm specializes in is, of course, data management. And one of the things that you can do is to project how much labor a company will actually require.
Absolutely.
And based on your study here in the Philippines, we're already working with three companies here in the Philippines and projecting towards the mostly BPO and call center industry.
Correct.
Right. What are the trends that you're seeing now?
So globally, as well as here in the Philippines, we're seeing that there's a lot of organizations are trying to get closer to their customers. And in doing so, they're trying to be more dynamic in the way that they bring their contact centers and their back office staff into bear. That means that everybody's focusing on customer experience. And that means for contact centers, we really need to have the right people, the right place, the right time, the right skill. And it's those components that we help organizations understand and bring in.
Right, and the goal is, of course, to cut costs on labor as well as to bring in the right kind of people, as you said, in the organization. But how do you do that, actually? Is it just a matter of putting in the technology, to ensure efficiencies?
No, I wish it was that simple. You say it's about cutting costs. In essence, that's true, but it's about becoming more efficient. So it's the same outcome, right? So if you can be more efficient with slightly less agents, then you are in a better place. You're in a much stronger position as an organization. If you can do that and increase customer satisfaction, then you're hitting all of your markers. So you get customers that love you a little bit more. You're paying a little bit less to achieve that. So it's a very fine line between those two.
Right, and based on your experience and also in Australia, coming from Australia and working with global brands, you're seeing a trend in terms of what kind of people to hire. We're not limited to fresh grads anymore or people who have constantly worked in the BPO or call center industry.
That's very true. It used to be the remit that it was where people went when they were at university, get a little bit of extra money and work in. But we're now seeing that that's absolutely changing. So there's a couple of different dynamics that are happening. The first one is certainly in places like Australia, the US, and I think we're seeing some of those trends here, trying to bring stay-at-home mums back into the workforce. And it's this need to understand exactly how many full-time employees I have, how many people I need full-time, but how do I use the market around me to help that dynamic demand?
Right, and do you also see retirees returning to the workforce these days?
Not so much retirees, but we're seeing people that are getting towards the end of their career that are now thinking that this is a great place for them to be. And that we've seen a lot of organizations deploy those in particular areas to say, well, depending on why people are calling, somebody that's 50, 60 might be a better person to be speaking to that rather than just trying to throw somebody that's 20, 25, 30. So you can now deploy the skill, the experience into the type of situation that it best suits.
Right, and how do we prevent attrition? We still see much attrition in the workforce these days. We're also trying to avoid a lack of productivity or a drop in productivity in these call centers and BPOs as well as other industries. How do we ensure that we avoid that?
So here in the Philippines, you tend to have a slightly higher attrition rate than you would see in, say, centers in Australia or maybe centers in the US. One of the things that we're finding is that you've got to work on that work-life balance. And a lot of the times, people aren't really forecasting their load. They're just looking at scheduling, just making sure they've got enough people, people sitting at seats ready for the calls. And there's very little ability to allow agents to actually manage that work-life balance. We said earlier on that there's still a lot of people that are coming into the market that have got more experience, but it's still predominantly the younger generation that are in the contact centres, they have work-life balance at the very core of what they do. So helping organisations to manage that at an individual level, not just at a corporate level, helps to reduce attrition. Because people will move not just for money, but if they can't get access to what they to feeling valued, to feeling that they have an ability to say when and how they want to work, they'll move to somewhere else. And that costs an organisation in two ways. Number one, they've got to get more people, but it's not just taking 6 weeks to train them. Speed to competency, as we call it, can take 6 months. So you lose so much more than just an individual.
Where does it start, this empowering of people? We, here in the Philippines, we have about at least a 10% unemployment rate. It's improving, but where does it start to make sure that the companies are well-staffed and the people are actually well-employed and not even underemployed?
Yeah, so look, contact centers, as an example, have been very good at making sure, understanding what it takes to bring somebody into an organization and make them ready to start talking to people. There is a gap between that and full competency, and we're seeing organizations take bite-sized chunks at education. So rather than try and give everybody, as they enter, all the information, they give them just enough, put them on the desk, give them a bit of experience, train them a bit more. But that doesn't really address the work-life balance. And what we find is that by truly understanding what it is an agent brings and what skills they have, and then allowing them to, say for instance, swap a shift with somebody else, but without having to go through all of the management protocols, by allowing technology to assist, that really can help people from to manage their own work-life balance. That's about empowering people.
Right. Do you have a best practice, company or country in mind that we may cite here? And where is the opportunity for the Philippine market here?
So rather than just put a name down, I'd say that obviously an Australian company, we have a lot of Australian clients. And in Australia, the banks tend to be the leaders of change. So we are seeing a lot of these changes enacting within the four major banks that are sitting in Australia and the second tier banks as well. So we see a lot of that activity. In the Philippines, there's less focus on actually forecasting the load. The skills that we bring to the market is not just about making sure they're the right people, right time, but it's standing back, having a look at this. Why are people calling to an organization? And how can we help an organization to better answer those queries? Maybe AI and some automation might be the right answer. Maybe taking it away from AI and automation might be the right answer, and getting that human interaction going as well.
And with the continued growth of POGOs as well as call centers and BPOs here in the country, of course, still a lot of opportunity there. Sean Mather, Executive Director of Call Design, thank you so much for joining us today and sharing your thoughts with us.
Thank you for having me here.
Thank you.